We're hosting a beer and wine gala for the cheerleading team in Hopkinton for to raise money to try to send them to nationals down in Florida. You know, I've coached a number of sports in town, the youth sports program, and I'll tell you, I haven't seen anything like what the girls have to go through quite often 6 days a week for several hours, 2-3 hours at a time, and the competitive nature of what it takes to do choreographed dance and gymnastics all at the same time, holding each other up, doing tumbling, et cetera. And there's the fall event, as well as the winter event that the teams go through to try to get a bid for nationals. So we had three goals in mind when we put the event together. One of them was to raise money to send the girls to Florida, as I mentioned before. The second was to make it a community event so that the town could get together to support the hardworking girls of town. And what we're gonna do is we have distributors coming in, and you'll be able to sample some higher end wines to get a sense for what they're like. 12 reds, 6 or 7 white wines, and we're also gonna have 6 to 10 beers, specialty beers that people will be able to learn about. The distributors will be talking about the different wines, give you the opportunity to ask some questions to get better educated, if you will, about some things that they might not normally get a chance to taste or use. And we're also gonna have some food, light snacking kind of food. It's from 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock, so some appetizers. And we have a DJ, Carl Adams, who's gonna play at the event to keep the spirit up and the spirit light. So it's an opportunity to mingle with town folks in addition to raising some money for the girls. There have been numerous opportunities for the girls over the years. One of the ones that I'm particularly blown away by is this year in the fall, they won 3 Tri-Valley League or TVL championships in a row. That's the first time that's happened. They've competed in the regionals and come in second place. Last year, they competed in the New England's and came in third place in New England's, the first time that that's ever happened where they've placed that high. They have a number of first place events, and the team has really gone from pretty much obscure 10 years ago to being a competitor and a top-notch player and placement in pretty much all of the events they go to, both invitationals, which are independents, as well as the school events. Community support is tremendous. You know, without the town supporting them from a financial as well as just, you know, being there to applaud and help them out, but also from the coaches. The coaches have been tremendous. You know, you need to know how to drive the girls, how far to drive the girls. It's very demanding on their bodies in addition to their minds. So, you know, bruises are quite common, sprains are the norm, and the coaches help them work through that along with the support, you know, of the town. In addition to music and some food and education about some wines that and beers that you might not normally get access to, we have some theme baskets. So a Celtics basket, a Red Sox basket, a barbecue basket that people who are going to the event, bought a ticket and are attending, will be able to bid on. Some of them are, you know, have some fun themes to them as well inside. So there's an opportunity to bid on those and win. And then if you're not able to make the event, buying a ticket, whether you go or you don't go, the ticket gets you the opportunity to be entered into a grand prize raffle where the ticket will be pulled out of a basket and you win a Bose surround sound system. So I encourage you all to come on out, support the cheerleaders of Hopkinton and their quest for a national bid to send them down to Florida to get some education about some wines and beers that you might not normally get access to, and to just have a general fun night in Hopkinton to get out of maybe all the snow that you've been shoveling the last couple of weeks.